What is time? Put simply, time is the passage of events from the past into the future. In my watch, a second passes when the quartz crystal inside oscillates exactly 32,768 times. That definition makes it seem like time is constant and uniform all across the universe. After all, this quartz crystal should vibrate at the same rate wherever it is, right? However, as it is, that is not true. Time can indeed pass at different rates depending on our reference frame. To wrap our head around this mind-boggling idea, let's take a quick detour to explore the speed of light. C is a universal constant that is fixed at about 300 million meters per second. This is because light is made up of photons. Photons are elementary particles with zero mass and always travel through space at a fixed speed. Thus, the speed of light is always measured as C by every observer. And that has a lot of repercussions. Imagine I'm aboard a high-speed train that is traveling at a constant velocity 90% the speed of light. It does, however, seem stationary to me as I have no way to know that it is moving. The light at the back of the train emits a photon traveling towards the front of the train. To me, the photon travels at 100% C and I record the time it takes to reach the front of the train. However, someone on the platform, who already sees the train moving at 90% C, sees the photon move at 100% C relative to the platform, but only 10% C relative to the train. So, from the platform observer's perspective, the photon takes a longer time to reach the front of the train and time seems to have slowed down for the person in the train. This phenomenon is called time dilation. For me, time always passes at a constant rate. However, to a person in a different reference frame looking at my watch, my time seems to pass differently than theirs. Let's consider a space-time graph representing four dimensions. From our perspective in an inertial reference frame, we are moving only through time at the speed of light. The interesting thing here is that we are all always moving at the speed of light through space-time, so increased motion through space is slower motion through time. Thus, when we see someone else moving in a different direction through space-time, we perceive their time passing differently. Now that we've established time is relative, have you ever thought about why we can move backwards and forwards through space, but only forwards through time? The answer lies in the second law of thermodynamics. Any system can only move from an ordered state to a disordered state. If I throw paint on this canvas, no matter how hard I try, I cannot unpaint it. In the universe, the degree of disorder only increases, so time always moves forward. Time may be a weird abstract concept, but its implications are significant. Sorry I'm late! Jokes aside, did you know that GPS satellites orbiting the Earth need to adjust their clocks regularly to maintain accuracy? Anyway, my time's suddenly running out. See you in the future!